Now, in addition to text files or groups of text that will be found throughout Linux, you're also going to have to deal with text streams. Now, the major difference between a text file and a text stream is that text streams are generally sent directly to the console or sent to the screen for viewing. So when you type the ls command, its output is going to be called sdout or standard output. We also have stdin, and this is going to allow us to put text streams into the file. And we also have stdir, or std, or standard error. And this allows us to grab any error messages that would normally be sent to the console. This can sometimes be confusing, especially if the output for a certain command produces a mixture of errors and successes. If you want to sort out the errors and only get the successes back, you can just simply reroute the standard errors to another area, such as a text file or to a null value. So our standard import, or stdin, is going to come from putting in values to programs. So if we want to, for example, ping several different machines at the same time, we can actually force, through a little bit of work with the text stream, force a list from a text file into the ping command and have that cycle through each. In addition, the results of that process that we're performing will produce a standard output where the program gives us feedback to the screen about whatever it is that we are doing. And as I mentioned, your standard error are any problems that are sent to the screen to alert you that the function is not working properly or the program failed. Now, we can control what happens to these text streams as they're being used. We can redirect them. We can push them to a file, for example. We can push them from a file to a program. And generally, we're only going to use output to files and in from text files. Now, there are a couple of different symbols to be familiar with when working with the text streams. First of all, you have your redirected to the SDN. So basically, that means that I can take a file and plug it into a program. If we want to redirect one of our outputs, our standard error or standard output, then we're going to use this symbol. So if we want to run the less my file, we're actually going to have the my file document output to the screen. But instead, we're going to redirect the text stream into a different file. Now, when we're using standard output, we're going to use the greater than symbol. Now, the greater than symbol is going to grab only positive output, whereas the to greater than symbol is going to be for error output. We can actually do both to one file or each to separate files if we like. And another neat feature is if we want to just do away with any errors that we have, then we can redirect the appropriate output text stream to dev null, and it will basically disappear. Now, anytime you use the standard redirect, it's going to basically recreate the file for you. That may not always be the desired outcome. So if you want to append to the file, then you simply use an extra greater than command. Now, in addition to a redirect, we can also use a pipe command or a pipe symbol. And basically, that's going to send either the output or the input to another program. So basically, if I want to ping a computer and the results of that ping need to be fed into another program, I can do that using the pipe symbol. As you can see, this example, we're actually using our ls command with what necessary switches we need, and we're going to pipe the results into the sort command. And the results of the ls command and appropriate switches are going to be used as input to sort. So we can actually bundle these programs together and push them all together into a ultimate outcome that we're desired. So let's take an example. A simple ls is going to show me the results of what exists inside of the particular directory. Now, if I want to, using our example, pipe the ls into a sort command, and I can even further redirect the sort into sortedfiles.txt. As you can see here, I've created a sortedfiles.txt. If I want to view that, here's an example. It's in alphabetical order, and it's actually in a text file. So I could actually send this off or use it as documentation if necessary. So as you can see, these are definitely useful situations. If I want to add to that again, for example, let's say I want to use the same command, but this time I'm not going to sort it. I'm going to put it in out of order, and I want to append it. So now we simply type in less, and we look at our file. You can see we have additional records. But now it's not in order anymore. So if I like, I can simply pipe it through. Let's say I want to sort it, for example. Then I will redirect the result of the sorted files . Now, as you can see, it actually went back through for me and took what was in the file. We used the less command to pull what's actually in the sortedfiles.txt out. We piped it into the sort command, and as a result of the sort command, we redirected into the really sorted.txt file. What this allowed us to do is take sorted files, which was not really sorted after we appended additional values to it, and sort it with an output of really sorted.txt. So there are a lot of available flexible options when using various commands with redirecting these text streams.